today I'm going to be discussing an application of Bayes' rule in medicine. Bayes' rule is a very useful tool for what's known as Bayesian updating. So anytime a particular test has less than 100% accuracy, Bayes' rule can be used to estimate the probability a patient has a particular disease given a positive or a negative test result. So in today's example, I'm going to be discussing an HIV test known as the OraQuick rapid test. The test parameters of the OraQuick are that it has a sensitivity of 99.1%. And sensitivity in this case refers to the probability that a patient has a positive test result given that he or she has the particular disease. The specificity of the OraQuick test is 99.6%. And we can think of specificity as sort of the complement to sensitivity. Specificity is the probability that a patient has a negative test result given that he or she does not have the disease. In the United States, estimates of HIV prevalence among adults is around 1%. This refers to the fraction of the adult population that's HIV infected. So what we're really interested in thinking about is, given a prevalence of only 1%, if a patient has a positive test, what's the probability that they actually have the disease? And we're going to be using an application of Bayes' rule to answer this question. We're going to begin by answering this question by drawing a probability tree. In this tree, uncertain nodes are represented by circles, and the branches correspond to a particular event that can happen. So in this case, the first branch is going to correspond to whether or not a patient has the disease or does not have the disease. Then from there, I can draw the second layer of branches. So this second layer refers to whether or not a patient has a positive or a negative test result. And note that both types of patients can have positive or negative test results. So in the example that I just mentioned in the United States, approximately 1% of the population is thought to have HIV disease, which means 99% of the population does not have the disease. So this number corresponds to what's called the prevalence. Given that a patient has the disease, the probability that they have a positive test result is referred to as the sensitivity. In this example, the sensitivity was 99.1%. That means the probability that they have a negative test is 1 minus this, or 0.009. Again, this is what's called the sensitivity. Similarly, the probability that a person without the disease has a negative test result is what's known as the specificity. And in this example, the specificity of this HIV test is 99.6%, or 0.996. That means the probability that a patient has a positive test is 1 minus this, or 0.004. So again, I just want to point out, at each stage in a probability tree, the branches must sum to 1. So at this stage, the branches sum to 1, at this stage they sum to 1, and at this stage they sum to 1. So we can sort of almost think of this as we have a stream of water entering the system, and at each circle node, it's being diverted either top or bottom. And at each stage, that probability has to sum to one. So the next step is to calculate the joint probabilities. This is done by multiplying probabilities along each branch. So let's take the first branch as an example. 0.01 times 0.991 is 0.0099. And I can do this for each one of the four branches. So 0.01 times 0.009 is 0.0001. The next one is 0.0040. And the last one is 0.9860. So these probabilities are referred to as the joint probabilities in the tree. And I should also verify that they sum to one. So the question, again, that we're actually interested in addressing is, if a person has a HIV positive test, what's the probability that they actually have the disease? So in order to answer that question, we're actually going to have to flip the tree. We want to flip the order of the branches. So now my first set of branches are going to correspond to a positive test or a negative test. And the next set of branches will correspond to whether or not a patient has a disease or no disease. The first step in flipping the tree is to match up the probabilities at the end of the tree. So from this, I refer back to the original tree. So we see the probability of having a positive test and the disease is equivalent to the probability of a disease and a positive test, or 0.0099. Similarly, if we look at the bottom branch, the probability of a negative test and no disease is the same as no disease and a negative test, or 0.9860. So we notice the top and the bottom branches stay the same. But what about the middle branches? So in this case, the probability of a positive test and no disease corresponds to no disease and a positive test, or 0.0040. And similarly, a negative test and disease is equivalent to disease and a negative test, or 0.0001. So again, we note if we take the original tree, the top two joint probabilities stay the same, and the middle two probabilities actually flip. Okay, so we have our joint probabilities at the end of the tree. Now we want to fill in the rest of the tree, sort of moving from left to right. So I first want to estimate the probability of a positive test result. Well, this is just the sum of these two numbers, 0.0099 plus 0.0040, which is 0.0139. And similarly, the probability of a negative test is the sum of this number and this number, which is 0.9861. And I should double check at this stage that these numbers do in fact sum to one, which they do. So the next step is I want to calculate the conditional probabilities at this stage in the tree. So let's define this probability by a variable x. As we saw in the previous case, we know that 0.0139 times x has to equal 0.0099. So just like last time, this times this has to equal this. I can then solve for x, which is just 0.0099 divided by 0.0139. And in this case, x equals 0.7145. And I can go through and do that for each one of the joint probabilities. So this number divided by this number is 0.2855, and so on. So from this tree, I can read the answer to the original question. So the original question was, given that a patient has a positive test, meaning given that they're on this branch of the decision tree, what's the probability they actually have the disease? So that turns out to be this number, 71.45%. So just to summarize what we found, we had a prior probability belief that a patient has HIV with probability 1%. Then we observe a positive test result. And then we can update our beliefs and form a posterior probability belief. And in this case, this is 71.5%. So even though we have a test that's over 99% accurate, because we have such a low starting prevalence, there's only a 72% chance that the patient actually has HIV, even though they've observed a positive test. So we're updating our beliefs. We previously thought it was 1%, then we observe a positive test result, and now we believe it's close to 72%. So sort of one of the main takeaways from this analysis is that Bayes' rule is the most appropriate, Bayes' rule is the most appropriate method for doing probabilistic updating. So I start with a belief on the probability of an uncertain event. I observe some new information, and then I update my beliefs to reflect that new information. And this is really the key purpose of Bayes' rule, whether it's in medicine or in any other industry. It's really to update our beliefs based on new information that we obtain.